Bizzibox's expert information on brow lift. What is a brow lift?
A brow lift is a procedure that elevates the eyebrow, and that's it in its very baldest, that's a bald statement of what it does. Because as we age, the whole brow area tends to droop, and that gives rise to a sort of hooded, tired look in the upper eyes.
Who are the best candidates for a brow lift?
The best candidates for a brow lift are people who can demonstrate that in their youth, or 10 or 15 years earlier, their brows were in a higher position with a better shape, and who now have got obvious descent of the brow. And again, a good quality skin, relatively little sun damage, they're all important factors.
Who should avoid a brow lift?
It is a complicated subject to talk about who should avoid having a brow lift, but anyone that has surgery around the eyes, it's essential that you have a proper assessment of the eye itself and the eyelid. And there are some people, for example, who've never had brows very high, who may look unnatural or startled if they have a brow lift. That also depends on the particular technique of a brow lift. The other people who should not have a brow lift surgery is exactly the same as those who shouldn't have facelift surgery, people who have poor health or taking certain medications.
Do I need to see my GP first?
If we were having this conversation 10 or 15 years ago, most people would see their GP, and most surgeons would suggest that patients see their GP. However, I think today most people access aesthetic surgery without going to their general practitioner. Personally, I feel it's important that any doctor who sees a patient who has a health problem should communicate with the general practitioner.
Do I need to prepare for a brow lift?
There are no specific preparations for a brow lift. Sometimes there are issues, again, which may be ophthalmological. And sometimes it's important to prepare the eyelids, and that may even involve a period of eyelid hygiene and cleaning, and sometimes even a course of antibiotics.
What is the procedure for a brow lift?
Like many procedures, there's no single brow lift, and brow lift has evolved over the last 10 years. I think that's very important because it's undoubtedly got very much better over the last 10 years. Early brow lifts tended to remove all the muscle in the between the eyebrow area, which allowed the brows to elevate. However, that often gave rise to brows that were too high and also weren't of a particularly natural shape. And that could give rise to a slightly startled, slightly unnatural look. As brow lifts have evolved, we concentrate much more on giving a better shape to the eyebrow. And the female brow, for example, has a classic shape which rises from the inside of the eyebrow to the outside. And that's what you're really trying to achieve with a brow lift.
What is the technical procedure for a brow lift?
Technically, a brow lift is usually carried out these days with the use of an endoscope. So it's done through two small incisions, and it's like a little camera surgery. You elevate all the brow tissue off the bone of the forehead, and then the muscle on the inside is gently elevated so that you manipulate the brow position, and then you fix the brow in that position, usually with a stitch that fixes the brow tissue down to the bone of the skull.
How long does a brow lift take?
An endoscopic brow lift, or a brow lift using these small incisions, actually doesn't take very long. And in experienced hands, this can be done in 30 to 40 minutes.
Is a brow lift painful?
Usually brow lifts are not painful. However, there are a small group of patients who experience headache after a brow lift, and it can be quite an annoying headache that's difficult to treat. It usually only lasts for about 24 to 48 hours, and it's quite rare. But for most people, pain is not a feature. What does happen with a brow lift is you will have numbness of the scalp. And actually, it's very important that people know that, because they need to avoid hot curling tongs and putting their hair under near something that might burn their scalp.
What can I expect after surgery?
After brow lift surgery, bruising is relatively rare. You may get some bruising which, oddly enough, is not in the brow area, but tends to sit underneath the lower eyelid. It's generally quite mild. The brow can look a little bit shiny and over smooth for a while, and also it can feel quite tight.
How long will I take to recover?
Recovery from a brow lift is much quicker than for a facelift, and particularly with the use of, if you've got a reasonable head of hair and using various hairstyles, many people can go back to work after 10 days.
What scars or incisions should I expect?
The great thing about an endoscopic brow lift is that the incisions are made within the hairline, and they're actually very difficult to see. I always tell patients that you can hide your facelift scars from a lover, but not from a hairdresser. Well, a brow lift, you can probably hide them from a hairdresser as well. Occasionally, you may get a slight widening of the scar in this area, which may be visible in certain partings. But again, I think modern techniques mean that's really unusual. So brow lift scars are pretty difficult to detect.
What advice would you give for aftercare?
The advice for aftercare with a brow lift is patients can wash their hair with an antiseptic shampoo or a medicated shampoo. The most important advice is to be aware not to use any hot hair dryers or anything that might damage the scalp when the skin is a little numb.
Are there any risks or side effects with a brow lift?
Actually, there are very few complications of a brow lift. Theoretically, you can injure or at least temporarily damage one of the nerves that lifts the eyebrow. And although that does happen from time to time, it's extremely rare for that to be permanent. other than that, I think it's important that people are aware that for a week or two, the brow may look rather high and a little bit over high, but that's actually natural in the first week or two after a lift.
What results can I expect?
I think for the right patient, a brow lift is a really rewarding procedure. And particularly for women, I think it allows women to wear eye makeup, which was difficult to do that before. It gives an open, fresh, interested look, and a really well-performed brow lift can have a fantastic effect in rejuvenating the face.
How long do the results last?
Brow lift has a very good record. In fact, a brow lift will last longer than a facelift, and that's usually because you're fixing the tissue back onto bone, and it's very hard for that to relapse with time. So most brow lifts will last a long, long time.
Can I get other procedures done at the same time?
Brow lift is often performed with other procedures, notably eyelid surgery. So a brow lift can also take place with upper eyelid surgery and occasionally lower eyelid surgery. And in terms of rejuvenating the whole face, brow lift is usually performed with a facelift.
Who can perform a brow lift?
Brow lift surgery is fairly specialised, and anyone carrying this out should have appropriate training and experience in this area. Again, it's usually surgeons that have a background in facial surgery. You also need to have specifically trained in competence with the endoscope, because it is done with a camera.
What qualifications should I look for in a surgeon?
Brow lift should only be performed by appropriately qualified surgeons, and most of these are plastic surgeons. Some ophthalmic surgeons are skilled in brow lift because this is their area of interest. In very broad terms, you're looking for someone who's a member of a professional organisation like the British Association of Aesthetic Plastic Surgeons, or in the case of an eye surgeon, the British Association of Aesthetic Eye Surgery.
How much does a brow lift usually cost?
The fee for a brow lift surgery will include the hospital stay, the anaesthetic fee and surgical fee. Usually it's done as an overnight stay, sometimes as a day case, and it'll cost somewhere between the region of £3,000 and £4,000.
www.bizzibox.com